employee as per on the American space and work for a pair of these invasive control system. Now, the commander of the outpost has called the situation a serious one, but not life-threatening at this time. We're taking a look at live pictures of the mission. Steve Harrigan has been following the story for us. Steve, thank you for joining us. Let's talk more about just how serious the situation actually is.
Well, my NASA officials have stressed from the very beginning that this would not be a potentially life-threatening situation for the six crew members on board the International Space Station, nor did they expect any power to be lost. But this has been an emergency space flight. Usually these things are well planned out in advance. This one really coming together just in the past 48 hours. This is after a leak of ammonia in the cooling system was discovered. Right now it appears that the two astronauts have been doing some high-tech plumbing for the past 4 hours. They've located the leak and they've replaced the pump, so it looks like a very successful job so far to stop what could have eventually been electric power on board that space station.
We'll take a look at those dramatic pictures. Of course, as you point out, this is a hastily arranged spacewalk. Anything can go wrong because NASA's not used to taking chances like this. They normally rehearse and go through these spacewalks with some lots of preparation. How do they find that there was actually a problem? And how did they find that?
It was actually crew members on board the International Space Station about 255 miles above the Earth who saw white flakes floating by out in space. It looked like snowflakes. This was actually bits of ammonia that had frozen. There have been problems in the past with the leak of ammonia last November, so it's surmised that maybe that could be a problem. Those two astronauts really are prepared to hastily exit and make repairs. That is part of the training for anything like this, which could go suddenly wrong. So there is training to respond to this, and also in Houston, astronauts training and really mimicking the actions of the astronauts up in space as well. So some thorough preparation, and it looks like they have managed to succeed so far. Testing the pump now, and a very positive attitude by the six crew members as well. They are tweeting this morning, "This is what we trained for years and years. It's a fun day." So a real positive attitude on the astronauts, despite the danger of the mission.
Indeed, a fun day. I certainly wear the best of the best on the astronauts, and I wish them well. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, look at Warrior living here all this weekend with all of us here. She gets a surprise guest from the Boston Farm. Plus, our interview with the second man to walk on the moon. She tells you why he's more than a human, the next one
here. Things on the face about trying to compete with other captains.
That's why my head retractors are engineered for maximum power and backed by a 5-year powertrain warranty. Yes, sir. The head retractors even have enough power for competition. Take a good look at the number one selling tractor. My head.
After 10 Ironman triathlons, over 40 week-long non-stop adventure races, and 13 years of firefighting, I definitely know a thing or two about pain. For relief, I don't like to take pills, and patches just don't work for me. So I trust Australian Dream, my friends made, because I can't let it slow me down. And with the empty jar guarantee, if you're not 100% satisfied, just return the empty jar for a full refund. Australian Dream works for me. Imagine what it can do for you.
My joints have gotten a little stiff lately, and at first I thought I had to live with it because of pro football and just getting older. Tastes great and it's easier to swallow.
Yeah.